Currently, more than 3 million people are living with epilepsy in the United States. In fact, it's the second leading cause of death from a neurological condition, which is why the Cameron Boyce Foundation has made it its mission to spread awareness after the tragic loss of actor Cameron Boyce in 2019. So joining me right now to talk more about the foundation are Cameron's parents, Libby and Victor. Thank you both so much for being here.
Thank you.
I know this is an extremely difficult topic to discuss, but coming from that, you guys have now made it your mission to give back and raise awareness. So why was that so important for you both?
You know, it's really about our love of Cameron. And what we have to remember is, you know, we have to think about what he would be wanting us to do. Mm-hmm. And I think it's just, it's a way to honor him. And it's a way to, heal is not the right word, but it's a way to kind of put our energy and our grief into something that's bigger than us. And that means something to the world and certainly something that is really important. And we know that he would expect us to do.
Tell me a little bit about your son. I was on social media beforehand coming into this interview, and I watched a couple clips and people talking about how great he was and how wonderful he just was to be around. What are some of the things that you guys remember the most?
Well, we always like to say that Cameron was the life of the party. Mm-hmm. Whenever he showed up on set or at a family function or anything, that's when the party started. That's when everything lit up, and he just had an energy that was just effervescent.
He never said a negative word about anybody or anything. He was definitely somebody that people gravitated to. He's sort of like, we used to just sort of describe him as Switzerland, like everybody would come to him for stable stability and just, you know, saneness. Mm-hmm. Very wise and just absolutely lovely person.
I love hearing you guys talk about him, yeah, because you can tell how lovely he was, yeah, and how much you guys cared about him, yeah, and still do. Yeah. Let's talk about the diagnosis. Yeah. I want you guys to explain, if you can, anything that parents or people should just look out for, because when I was reading this, and correct me if I'm wrong, his seizures weren't frequent by any, mm-hmm, means when he was growing up.
Right, mm-hmm, right. Well, he never had them until he was about 16. Okay. And then you're diagnosed with epilepsy once you've had more than one. Mm-hmm. And really, it's about ensuring, I mean, times when hormones change and so on is when you're a little bit more at risk for epilepsy. So the point is for everybody to know that it is possible 1 in 26 people get epilepsy in their lifetime. Mm-hmm. You need sleep. You need, you know, to take care of yourself. You need to, you know, not drink too much. You need to just be less stressed and so on. So there are a lot of things that, you know, as young people growing up, there's lots of triggers for them around those issues. You know, Cameron just kind of came out of left field with his first seizure, and he had one every year or so. Mm-hmm. So it was not something that we thought was like, yes, it was a big deal, but it wasn't a life-threatening thing. And, mm-hmm, we thought because he was in his bed, he was safe and, you know, he wouldn't fall and hit his head. So it's really hard to say what parents should look for, but, mm-hmm, just know that it's a possibility and, you know, be sure to take care of yourself, your health.
Let's talk about the candle and also the campaign. So tell me a little bit about both.
So the candle is, mm-hmm, a lavender candle, mm-hmm, and lavender is the color that we choose. Lavender may have calming effects when you smell lavender. So it's a good thing, like she just said, to stay calm and be peaceful to help hopefully prevent or avoid a seizure. But it's also the color of epilepsy awareness. Mm-hmm. So purple is. And so we choose to wear these colors, and hopefully people will like them and like the candle.
I think they're lovely.
And like the product.
The candle.
And you know, buy these things and help support us in what we're trying to do and raise funds for epilepsy awareness especially.
Candles are great.
Everyone
Christmas
loves candles.
Yeah,
stuffers,
I was about
you
to
name
say
it.
Yeah.
And
holidays.
Who doesn't, yeah, like lavender? Like, mm-hmm, lavender is beautiful. It's a beautiful flower. It brings butterflies. It brings insects. It brings everything. And it's just a life-affirming plant. And so we put it in a candle, and we're, you know, getting donations off of it so we could do more epilepsy awareness.
This is great. So where can people go to get more information, to possibly help, donate, fundraise, whatever?
It's the CameronBoyceFoundation.org. Mm-hmm. And the site is very dynamic. It's not a boring, mm-hmm, site. It's constantly changing. There's great information. Like you asked about what can people do. There's things we have our Now What campaign. We have support groups on Facebook. Mm-hmm. There's lots of things to help people mm-hmm. because we didn't have these tools. We weren't armed with enough information at right. all. So part of our main mission is to give people the tools and awareness to help them where to go, what kind of hospital to deal with, mm-hmm. what kind of doctor to talk to, these types of things. So. Right. CameronBoyceFoundation.org is where you go.
Lots of resources and information. Thank yes. you both so much for being here.
Of
I really
course.
Appreciate it.
Thank yes. you for having us of and course. Happy holidays.
Yes. Thank you, Kalina.
Of course. And